Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of Back to the Future, the video game. We are now doing the final episode of the game. Not like a final part, because I'm no one gonna be able to finish this, but we're doing episode 5, so the final episode for the game. So hopefully you will enjoy. So let's get started. Oh boy.
Hello?
Marty! You're awake! Good!
Emmett, where are you?
I'm down at the expo. I snuck out early to avoid my pop. If he knew I was about to make a publicly scientific spectacle of myself, he'd hit the roof.
Well, stay put. I'm on my way.
First, I need you to perform an important mission. On the table next to my law books, there's a device plugged into the wall.
I think I see it.
Is it glowing?
Yeah. Is that good?
Good? It's fantastic! Glowing means my static accumulator is charged up and ready for action. Bring it down to the high school and we'll... Damn!
What?
It's Edna!
But... Okay, Emmett. One static accumulator coming up.
Okay.
Yeah. Jeez, Doc. Watch out. You almost ran me over.
Sorry about that, Martin. This vehicle is sometimes difficult to control.
Yeah. Hey, are you okay? After that argument about Emmett last night...
I'm fine. Thank you for asking.
So, how are the time circuits?
Still broken. I've got a few ideas, but I'm occupied with other problems today. So, is that what I'm destined to build for the expo?
Yeah, it's a static accumulator. Emmett spent all night building it. Turned out he didn't really need to see Frankenstein after all. He just needed a little push. And some lightning.
Fascinating. I also had an epiphany last night.
Doc?
I realized that it wasn't Edna that made my life miserable.
Doc!
It was science!
You can't watch...
You guys probably want to see mostly...
What the hell?
Late, so... That conversation, I know, is really
Where'd
long,
it go?
So... Yeah. Because last episode, which is still uploading for me, because I just finished recording that... Marty and Emmett had a very long conversation, which took like 10 minutes up.
Like, oh, come on!
1 minute, just some gameplay.
Like, yeah, one little static thingy.
Just doing some gameplay. And then that 10 minute cutscene, and 10 minutes, and then we got back to the gameplay, and then the episode ended with another cutscene. So, yeah, it was kind of crazy. Okay, so we're gonna get it the second it gets close.
Now. Gotcha!
There we go. Whoa! Ouch.
future is coming today. There's a shiny new tomorrow on the way. A day of invention is at hand. It's a mystic, futuristic wonderland. Just around the bend, my friend, you'll see a dream or two. If you care to dream and dare to dream, your dreams can all come true. There's a world of wondrous wonder on display.
Not bad, eh? Not bad at all, but I thought you fired her. I found a loophole. What kind of loophole? Just a loophole. You're not the only one who's allowed to have secrets, you know.
All right.
Say, don't you have to get that whatchamacallit to Emmett Brown's booth?
Huh? Oh, yeah, right.
Because the future is coming. It's almost here now. The future is coming. It's getting clear now, the future is coming today.
Okay. That was, well, an interesting song.
And here he comes, and Waver.
Hello, Corleone.
Where's Emmett?
What? Is he missing?
Don't you recognize a ploy when...
Wait a minute, that's Emmett's levitator up there.
Oh, don't be so modest. I'd say you deserve at least half the credit. It was you who tricked poor Emmett into breaking up with me. It was you who manipulated him into dropping my project in favor of this clear hazard to public safety.
It was my
Oh, I think you know at least not the way poor Emmett thinks it is.
How do you know this?
I had a very I found out who Michael Corleone...
Is there something you want to tell me?
Why don't you call... Yakov!
Thanks a lot, Doc. Annie, you don't believe any of this bullshit, do you?
Sorry, Yakov, but I really don't have a choice.
Very good. And...
Come here.
Okay.
Look, here's the thing. I happen to believe this dame's got a screw loose. But she's been getting some clout in town, ever since that business with Kid Tannen.
But Emmett's gotta fly that electrokinetic levitator at this demo. His whole future depends on it.
And my future depends on making sure he doesn't. The chief reads her column religiously. Well, if I don't do what she says, she's gonna start a campaign to have certain tainted officers removed from the force.
Oh,
isn't
boy.
There anything I can do?
Not unless you've got some dirt on Edna. Something that'll discredit her in the eyes of the law. Well?
I'll dig something up.
You do that. In the meantime, you and young Mr. Brown better... Where is he anyway?
Wait, you haven't seen him?
Emmett? Has this foreign rat...
Maybe you should find him.
Oh! You're le...
Okay, so, I gotta find Emmett. And do something about Edna.
Okay. Oh, now we have a goal.
Greetings!
Hi, Trixie.
That's Techni to you, kiddo.
Right. Congratulations on getting the old job back.
Thanks. Justice triumphs in the end, you know? Now, what can I do you for?
So, which exhibits do you recommend?
The most popular attractions are the Glass House, the Future Furnishings, and of course, Enlightenment. You know who that is under the dive? Of course, you need to get tickets if you want to see the
How much are tickets?
Aw, put your money away. Here, you're kind of like family now, you know?
Thanks. Thanks.
Happy to help.
Okay.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification, a push of a button away.
This plant doesn't belong here. There's nothing futuristic about it. potted plant? What's this got to do with law enforcement? It's a bug.
No, a plant. But it's got a wire recorder hidden inside, see? If we could have got one of these into Tannen's speakeasy, and if he's the kind of guy who talks to plants, we could have busted him a lot earlier.
Okay. Well, now let's try this.
Why?
Okay.
Greetings again, mortals! This is Techni, Muse of Progress. Hoping you're all having a swell time taking in all the exhibits. Don't forget, you can purchase tickets to our main attractions right here at the information booth.
Detective Parker's secret police recorder. Just like a regular potted plant, but with a recorder inside. Okay, call me a snoop.
Okay, here we go.
Welcome to the world of tomorrow, where a man's home is truly his castle. Here, gratification is just always a push of a button away. In the house of the future, fresh fruit baskets will be replenished daily by fleets of fruit-bearing helicopters.
That's not the bun I wanted. Green bun, that's what that is.
In the house of the future, phone conversations will be completed in the privacy of the personal phone helmet.
Hey!
Please recite the phone number you wish to dial. Experience.
Klondike 4385.
Brown residence.
Hey, Hampton. How's it hanging? This is Marty, Emmett's friend. Is he there?
Not at the moment. I'm afraid he's off on one of his little adventures.
Thanks. Bye.
Farewell.
Conversation terminated.
Okay, here we go.
In the house of the future, phone conversation.
Please experience.
Klondike 425.
Hill Valley Expo, where the future is.
This is Carl Sagan.
Ooh, the mysterious Mr. Sagan. What do you want?
Can you put Edna Strickland on the phone for me?
Sure thing, Mr. Sagan. Hey, Strickland! Somebody actually wants to talk?
Mr. Sagan, I didn't expect...
You didn't?
Yes. Wasn't that part of our plan?
Yes, our plan. Why are you saying all those terrible things about...
Young comrade Smirnov, you were the one who told me about his bike.
I'm a little unclear on the details of our plan.
Unclear?
I mean, I'm worried that you're a little unclear on the detail.
What details? All I'm supposed to do is use my poll with Detective Parker to get Emmett's demonstration canceled while you keep Emmett distracted. You are keeping...
Oh, yes. He's a very distractible young man.
Oh, that's what I keep telling everyone.
There's been a change of plan.
What?
Yes, I've changed my mind. I think we should let Emmett go.
But you told me it could be dangerous and that Yakov Smirnov was a foreign agitator. That the only way...
But I was a little crazy at the time. The important thing is, now I think you should let Emmett go ahead with his little demonstration.
Oh, I get it.
What?
It's Comrade Smirnov, isn't it? He's gotten to...
No! I really...
Don't worry, Carl. You can count on me.
Guys, you can listen to... I'm gonna turn off my mic for a second. Okay.
Can you guys hear the, whatever it's called, music in the background?
Sorry guys about that. I got called by my cousin on Skype, so I had to deal with that.
After I started the fire, I could have gotten clean away, and I never would have had to divert suspicion to you.
She's the speakeasy arsonist.
Carl, is somebody with you?
No, it's just you and me. You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Okay, here we go.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them. Every night they'd open up their doors serving illegal drinks and loose women, flaunting their depravity to the world, and the authorities did nothing. So I did what any right-thinking, rock-willed woman would do. I took action. Oh, and such a gorgeous action it was, too.
Oh, boy.
The fires were so beautiful. The alcohol made them go up in such pretty blue flames. Where was I?
You were explaining why you burned down the speakeasies.
Yes. Did you find my answer to your liking?
It was very revealing. Hang up.
What?
Jeez, Edna was always a loon. I hope that confession's good enough for Parker.
There we go.
Next up on our roster, a man who saw the possibilities in pond scum. Welcome, Ernest Philpot!
Thanks, Trixie. I'm truly honored to be here today among all you pointy-headed type people. Like the lady said, I labor in the field of pond scum.
I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all...
I think a lot of people are going to be interested...
Casual. He's...
Hey, Danny.
Do you mind, comrade? We're busy trying to protect the expo from the likes of you.
This'll only take a minute.
Our plant recorder. It's not a good idea to steal police property, you know.
Listen.
You know, I don't think I ever asked you why you burned down all those speakeasies.
Why? Because no one else was doing anything about them.
Oh boy.
Detective Parker. Surely you're not going to believe this crudely manufactured forgery of a recording.
I'm not sure what to believe, ma'am. But based on this crudely manufactured forgery, if
afraid I'm going to have to ask you to come down to the station to answer a few questions about your whereabouts on the night of the speakeasy fires.
Oh, very well. Heavens, what's that?
You know,
oh boy.
One of these days I should really stop falling for that.
Hey, does this mean that the barricades can come down from Emmett's booth?
Let's take that as a yes. Emmett's gotta be around here somewhere.
Thank you, Ernest. Do be sure to drop by his booth and sample an algae cake. I have, and it was very interesting. I will be back later to highlight another of our fine exhibitors. See you soon.
Okay. Well, guys, hopefully you did enjoy this episode, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.